the Running Man and the WAP and
those were not our dances.
What dance was you doing?
We were doing TLC. Do you know we made up a lot of our dances?
What dance? Well, I'm saying, I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about people in their car.
Okay, my bad.
In their office. I know you made up your own dance. You got Chili Live in studio right here on the People Station V103. And T-Bob's on the phone line. Hi, T-R.
Hi, take a
break. She got you beat.
Yeah, it was because I don't want any cues to come up here accusing me of stuff.
Oh, you're right.
So I'm just going to keep it real. Okay.
Right.
Chili. Chili's live in studio. Theon on the phone. TLC, Crazy Sexy Cool. 4.5 million viewers. Women, it was a whole generation of people who grew up listening to your music who absolutely were like, we have to tune it. Like, we have to see it. We have to understand why this happened, I've understood that you are executive producers of the film. Tell me about the sleepover, though, that you had with the actresses before they really started filming.
Oh, yeah. I had everybody to come over to the house, me, T, you know, the girls, and, you know, we cooked and we just talked about, you know, a lot of stuff and just not necessarily always talking about the script or giving them more information. We wanted them to see how Tion and I interact and the chemistry that's naturally there between us so that they could, you know, like pick up on those things, our mannerisms, everything.
Yeah.
You know? So it was important to us for them to be around us like that so that they could, you know, do an amazing job.
And then can I add something?
Yes, you may.
I'm sure she had her hand up.
Well, what I wanted to say was is that also, and past the script, you know, when we did sit down and talk about that, we wanted them to understand it past words, like what our passion was behind it, why we were so upset at certain times, why we were so happy at certain times. Mm-hmm. So they would really get a better understanding of the scene and what the feeling was. Because, you know, you can read words and all three of us can read it and get a different, you know, meaning.
Right.
So we wanted to go in depth in a way to where, you know, it would help them play their characters better because they understood why we were so passionate of each scene.
Indeed, like busting up in Clive Davis' office.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that was so bananas. Like, when I look back, I'm like, we were some rowdy little girls.
Yeah.
Indeed. So, the drama and the talk of the town and the nation is somebody is really upset. That would be Pebbles.
And I guess Crystal now, too.
Well, Crystal, too. But Pebbles more so, you know, she's quoting.
Than anybody.
She's quoting scripture. And she's saying all these things about how she's being improperly portrayed in the movie. And y'all are being slanderous. And she might file suit. Well, I'll just let you individually respond to such.
Can I start?
Yeah, come on, bring it. I like when you tell it.
Oh, hush up. No, and before I start with Pebbles, I just do want to say this about just overall, so in just period.
Tiana, are you on a, you know, we keep hearing a beeping sound.
She breakdancing. Go ahead, girl. Tell the story.
I'm not doing anything. I'm just on my show, but I don't hear anything.
Okay,
I'm sorry.
Going.
Can y'all hear me clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. All I was going to say is, like, you know, with the wrong and the right, did everything happen correctly all the time? Like, you know, the way we kicked Crystal off the group? No, it wasn't. But we're telling the story of the truth of what really happened. Mm-hmm. I'm not sitting here pretending like everything was hunky-dory and every decision I made back then was correct, but I always tell the truth. I've never been a liar, okay? Mm-hmm. So, Crystal, I mean, yeah, I would be mad if I got kicked out of my own group, too, and TLC blew up. I would have some harbor feelings, so I understand hers, but next. Anyway, so sorry. But on to Pebbles. We've always stated everything. The one thing you can't take from her is we've always said she's helped us out so much. Like, you wouldn't even know us if, you know, she didn't put us together and put us out. You know, she did a lot for our career.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that you can't take. But if you're telling a story, and it's even 20 years ago, say, I'm 43 now, so say I don't even feel the same.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I said, say. This is hypothetical. But the point is, if you have a relationship and, you know, you can't tell somebody how they perceived situations from their end, how they felt, the way you may have handled things, that doesn't take away the good that you did. But if there's things that we didn't agree with or didn't like, and the way things went down, we don't have to. And we're telling a story of what happened. Now, we're 19, 20, and that's exactly what happened. But now, up to date, do we feel differently about, you know, the money and stuff like that? No, I didn't appreciate paying $1 million per name.
Nope, sure didn't.
For TLC. Wow. There's certain things that we don't have to like. That don't mean I'm sitting up here like, oh, I hate her. We don't. We've right. always said, I have no hard feelings. We could sit down and eat tomorrow. But will we be back in business, people? No, because people grow apart. And that's okay. You move on from certain people. Right. That's okay. But we never took that from you. We never said that you didn't help us. We never said that we go around having problems with you. And I'm not a bitter person. I'm not a grudge holder mm-hmm. because that just hurts me. I let things go and I move on. And that's what I did, move on.
Indeed. So see, that's why I said I wanted you to tell
her. Still tripping over all of that.
Yeah.
Indeed. So we have we got T-Bobs on the phone. Chili's live in the studio. You can tune in and turn up at watchv103.com. I am going to, we're going to take a quick break. I'm gonna ask like two more questions. We're going to play a new song off the new album out in stores right now. And that's what it is. In the meantime, in between time, let me help you get through this ATL traffic. Again, Tiana and my girl Rosanna, better know Chili and T-Bobs. We turned up right here on the People's Station V103. Charlie Seal, what's happening on these ATL streets?
All right, Big Tigger.